I'm Jack Holgrave, and I'm here to talk about how the MLB playoffs will look this year. Here's my prediction on how it will play out. So first, I have the Boston Red Sox clinching their division despite their very slow start this year, but once they get going, they'll be a very hard team to beat. To fill the other two spots, I have the Cleveland Indians and the Houston Astros. Cleveland has a well-rounded team led by the ace pitcher Corey Kluber. The Astros, on the other hand, have much more playoff experience, and also they, in my opinion, are the best team in the league this year. As a wild card, I'll put the Yankees. This star-studded lineup should be a very close second to the Boston Red Sox. They have many all-stars, including Giancarlo Stanton, Rookie of the Year Aaron Judge, and all-star Gary Sanchez. I predict for my second wild card that the Oakland A's will make it. Between them and the Yankees, I think the Yankees will win against the A's. So this means that the Yankees will play the Astros, but I believe that the Astros will beat them in a five-game series, so this leaves the Red Sox and the Indians. The Red Sox are a much better team, so they'll end up playing in the ALCS against the Astros, but the Astros will be going all the way to the World Series. Now, for the National League, I predict that the Dodgers will easily make the playoffs. They've been to the World Series the last 2 years, but have lost both times. This year could be different. In the East Division, I predict that the Braves will win it with not too much breathing room. In the Central Division, the Red Hot Brewers will be coming back to the playoffs and clinching their division. As for the two wild cards, I'll have the Chicago Cubs, but it'll be very close. The other team I have taken the wildcard spot are the Phillies, but they are very close second to the Braves. Between the two wildcards, the Phillies will come out on top, so this means the Phillies will play the Dodgers, but the Dodgers should make quick work of them. In the other series, I predict it will be a 7-game series, but the Brewers will squeak by the Braves, but the Dodgers will end up beating them and advance to the World Series. In the World Series, it will be a 6-game series between the Dodgers and the Astros, but I predict that the Dodgers will come out on top and it will be revenge from the 2017 World Series.
Today we're going to be talking about Air Jordan. Air Jordans, they release about 100 pairs of shoes like in a year. And most of the shoes are like them bringing back, like not replicas, but like redoing shoes that have come out in the past, or they'll just redo a whole entire shoe. And today we're going to be talking about the Retro 11 Snakeskins, which are a shoe that they brought, that they were first originated in around the 1990s. They come in three different colors, which are the blue snakeskin, the bone snakeskin, which kind of looks like a rattlesnake, and then they have a watermelon snakeskin, which is looks more like a pink than a watermelon. Like these shoes came back from the 1990 era, and they were just recently brought back a couple days ago in 2019, and they re-brought back the blue ones, which are the new colors. The original ones were just the rattleskin kind of ones, and they brought back new versions of it, which were the blue and the pink. And those are all shoes that are going to be coming out like soon. Like the blue ones, they came out a couple days ago, and then the pink ones come out like mid-May, and then the rattlesnake ones come back out a little bit after the pink ones come out. And today, and that's it. We're just gonna be that's all we're talking about today, which was the Jordan releases.
Are youth sports too competitive? In my opinion, youth sports are not too competitive. But that's coming from me, and if you didn't know, I'm really competitive. When I watch my brothers play, I rarely see any contact, but when there is, my mom always gasps and says, "Oh, that was way too hard," but they were barely even touched. Yeah, sure, some kids will get physical if they are losing or really competitive, but I feel that's fine as long as it doesn't hurt someone. The older folks are saying that this generation is soft and we need to be more aggressive, but if you look at players now and players back then, it's no comparison. Our generation has produced much better athletes. And yes, I will admit that obesity in kids is more common nowadays, but the competitiveness is still there. If you want to decrease competitiveness, rec leagues should have balanced teams and not selective teams or teams you want to be on. I say this because I've been on teams that are where all my close friends are on, and we just completely dominated the league. But my opinion stays the same in that youth sports are not too competitive.
Hi, I'm Zamar, and I'm here to talk about our 8th grade Derby's trip to Cedar Point. On the last day before school ends, we will be all going to Cedar Point as an 8th grade. Sign up has been the last couple of days, and we're all excited for Cedar Point because we all get to go on the rides, and it's going to be the last time that we all get to hang out together as an 8th grade class. I'm mostly excited just because I get to hang out with all my friends for the last time before summer starts, because not all of us will be going to the same high schools. So, I think everybody should go to Cedar Point just for the experience of having all the rides. Like, me personally, I don't like roller coaster rides at all, but I'm going just for the fun of it, just to hang out with all my friends. And one thing that I did like about how the school set up the trip was how we were able to all choose on what buses we want to be out with our friends. Well, that's it, guys. Thank you for tuning into our show. We'll see you guys next time.